J.schreck, we are in the middle of absolutely nowhere today. You know, we've been wanting to do Lousy Canyon for a long time, and we decided today was the day. We thought maybe it wasn't muddy enough to get through, and I'm telling you what, it's about 26 degrees right now, and it's unbelievably cold, and the wind's blowing. And we're on the journey to try to find Lousy Canyon and the Lousy Canyon ruins. And man, the road to get here, you better want to come here because you're not going to stumble into this one. This one was incredible. Look at this canyon. There's John and Maria down there. There's the truck right there. That's the... I'm gonna say the road we took in, but you can't really call it that because it isn't much of a road. So, you know, what we got is a quick, easy hike. I got my new inserts. I've had my shots. Today's the fifth day, so, you know, I'm not gonna hike hard, but it's supposed to be 0.4 going in. So I'm gonna take my time and just pick my way through. And this had been an adventure, I'm telling you. This is crazy. The wind is blowing. This is the first time the wind's blown up here for a while, and I tell you what, it is colder than hell. So let's take a look. Okay, one thing we're seeing right now, okay? Right there is the pond. That's what I'm guessing that is right there. You know, when you're looking on the map, the hard thing is you're trying to figure out if, you know, you don't see, you know, canyons and things like that sometimes or the degree that they are. But that's telling me if that's that lake down there, that means that somewhere on the top of this hill is what I'm looking for. And I'm telling you what, man, it is cold out here. So look at this beautiful. And there's John right down there. There's the truck. I've already hiked farther than I wanted to hike today. I've got to get to this because, you know, I'm not going to blow my foot out today hiking across here. So, somewhere up in here, hopefully, is what we're looking for. And I've got to get to it pretty quick because I'm not going to get my foot. It's not going to like the scenario that I'm putting it through. So, if you look at these rocks, this is Agua Fria hiking to a T. You can't see what you're hiking on. None of the volcanic surface. And I can only imagine what the ancients dealt with, you know, when they're walking on almost bare feet. How incredible that had to have been and difficult of a life it would have been up here. Now, hopefully, when I peek up over here, I see the ruins. Now, I'm guessing they're over here, but that's just a guess. Hopefully, it's an educated guess, but it's a guess. So I was hoping as soon as I peak this hill that I'm going to find the Lousy Canyon ruins and find that wall, that pristine wall that is up here. So my feet are telling me, do not go crazy today. So I'm gonna take a nice easy. Tell you what, I'm seeing something right here that's making me pretty excited because, man, I do not want to walk much farther than I'm walking today. I see walls though, what appears to be walls right over here, right there. And I'm sure hoping that that's what that is. So like I said, the one thing I do not want to do is push my foot today beyond what its capabilities are. But that definitely looks like walls right in front of me. And if it is, I'm going to be extremely happy because I'm telling you what, this wind is whipping through up here. Here's a cow trail and we'll follow it, which should make the going a little easier. But those definitely are ruined walls right there. Now, one thing we've learned up here also is that, you know, there's groups. So usually if you find one ruin, there's groups around this. There's coyote tracks. So one thing we're going to find out is, you know, what's here. This ground here is a little easier to walk on. There's a little less volcanic material. The cows are giving me a really good trail. And there's my wall right there. Wow. I'll tell you what, you don't know how happy that makes me that we found the first wall. The walls look extremely well preserved. Here's the thing, you're not going to just stumble into this one. You're going to take a beating. And we bottomed that FJ out two or three times, and the skid plates got put to good use. Now, what I'm excited about is this is so hard to get to that the area's got to be pristine that we're working on, because you're just not going to stumble into this area. And I'm excited because what I'm seeing is an extremely pristine wall right there. That is absolutely incredible. Incredible. And because of the logistics of this location, I'm expecting to see just pristine walls. Now we're looking for that inner wall that was there. Look at those walls. Isn't that beautiful? Look at that wall. Now this is the beautiful thing about getting into a place that has not been touched and it's hard to get to. Look at that wall. Look at this. That is spectacular. That is the inner wall we've been looking for right here. That is the inner wall. Wow. That's the one we saw from space. Right there. Wow, look at this. This is incredible. Man. This is the square wall we've been looking for, right here. Wow. Isn't this beautiful? This is so impressive to see this. It is so impressive to see this. Man, this is a big deal. We worked really hard to get to this place. Man, I feel really terrible that James wasn't here today. because, you know, this is a big deal to get to find these places. This has been such a journey to find Lousy Canyon because of the attempts we made to get in here. The road is just unbelievable. Look at where we came from, way over there. So, I mean, you look at this and you look at this remote location and it's just hard to believe that, man, we found it. That is so cool. And man, I found it just in time before my feet, you know, decided that they didn't want to cooperate. Now look at these rocks right here. This is pretty incredible also. So we're gonna take a look around, see what we've got here. So we've got ruins all the way through here. All the prickly pear. Wow. Look at that right there, look at that pot. Isn't that beautiful? A good sized piece right there. Like I said, the good thing is, you know, this so far out here, you feel so privileged to get to come out here and see this stuff, that you get an opportunity to see, you know, where these ancients lived. And what a beautiful location. Look at this. So what I'm looking for right now is a kitchen. I'm looking for cliff walls. I'm looking anywhere where they might have done petroglyphs over here. The rock at Agua Fria is different. There's different forms, and some of it's really excellent for petroglyphs and some of them is not. So I'll be curious to see if they were able to use this in any form. But I'm really looking out because I know I'm in a pristine place right here. And I tell you what, when you think about the ancients, you just think about the lives they lived here. As difficult as it could have been, you know, there were some things about it that was really unbelievable. Look at this view. Look at that canyon. That is absolutely incredible. And we're gonna step up to the edge of it regardless. I'm gonna push my foot a little bit, because what I'd like to do is I'd like to see what's down here. Look at that canyon, man. Look at that. Oh my gosh, look at that. Look at that wall right over there. That is unbelievable. I'll tell you what, seeing that wall over there is one of the most incredible things I've seen. Now, I saw a picture of that on the internet, but I never actually saw it. And to see it over there is, it's really, really a big deal. I'm gonna kind of walk along this ledge a little bit as I travel through here. You know, I'm not gonna kill myself today, but this is, I'm hoping for some petroglyphs though. And I'm hoping right there is petroglyphs. I was hoping there'd be petroglyphs right there, but I don't see them. So I'm gonna work my way along that ridge over there, take a look right in that area right there. And then if there's none there, then for some reason, you know, even maybe the rocks just weren't the kind of rocks that we look at. But I'll tell you what, you know, Lousy Canyon, maybe because of the road, but it sure ain't because of the beauty of this location. This location is spectacular. You know, as we walked down that ridge line, I kept thinking that if there was a place that I thought possibly could have petroglyphs, it was going to be over here. And isn't that funny, because I'm going to take my time and get down here, and not, since I am hiking by myself, but there are petroglyphs right there. Yeah, we're gonna be able to get, looks like, right down through here. Now we're gonna play it safe because John's about a half mile from me, and he doesn't know where I'm at. So, last thing you wanna do is something stupid. I don't have time to be stupid today, so. We're going to take our time, pick our way through here, because it has been dug. But you feel like you're one of the few that have got an opportunity to see this down here, and we somehow got to work our way around that point. Let's see what's over here. Because you need to look, because you don't know what you're going to see here. Now we're going to work our way through here. Well, not a lot to see, but there are petroglyphs. Make sure there's nothing on that ridge line right there. And I don't see anything. We're gonna try to hike up and out that way instead of going the way we came in, which was not easy. Something there, but wow. Man, that wall is unbelievable. You know, every time we do a location, you know, I like to sit here and just kind of ponder about, you know, the life that they lived up here. You know, and their experiences, you know. They had hope and dreams like everybody does. And you know, life is so much of how you look at it, right? What you perceive life to be. And you know, you could have lived up here and this could have been the greatest life ever. But you know, you see those walls across there and you realize that, you know, they had their trials and tribulations. They absolutely did. And yeah, you can see my stand moving because the wind's blowing. Can you imagine being up here in a loincloth with animal skins trying to stay warm as well? So this has really been a fascinating experience getting to this ruin. You know, specifically because of the degree of difficulty. It was so difficult to get here. And the journey is taken. And I, as happy as I am, I'm a little saddened because me and James have been on these adventures a lot. And, you know, it means a lot that we both get to experience this. But, you know, life comes up. You got to do stuff you don't want to do. But, man, what an experience this has been at Lousy Canyon. And they didn't name this one right because Lousy Canyon is pretty unbelievable. What a beautiful place. And we found a few petroglyphs, which is cool. You always want to find a few petros. But I mean, I look at this view and I'm just in awe. I'm awe-inspired of the life that they got to live here. This wall being intact is still pretty cool. You know, when I see shards, you know, I think a little different. I think about, you know, the remnants of the past, you know, where, you know, if you touch them, you're touching the same thing that the ancients touched 600 to 800 years ago. And that to me is really, it's really where it's kind of cool. When you get that connection, because that's really what you're trying to do is connect with your past. You know, you look at that and I'm like, what went on in there? You know, it might have been divided, but that was a big room. You know, was that a room where there were ceremonies? Was that a room where, you know, maybe there were marriages, maybe there were, you know, whatever form of funerals. You know, they had connections with each other. And then you see grounds like this right here. And, you know, I automatically think, you know, some type of ceremonial fires, things like that. Right here, flat stone put together. That could have been, you know, cowboys out here. Because this was definitely ranching land. And it has been for hundreds of years. So when I see this kind of stuff, I always kind of reminisce about, you know, the lives that they lived.